Hey Polish fans, it's Caroline again and welcome to another video here at Wild Moon Lacquer. If you're new, hi, my name is Caroline and I like to talk about nail polish, and occasionally you will see my cats join me and you'll also see the occasional jewelry or makeup video. So if you like those kind of things, hit the little subscribe button down below, that way you don't miss out on any of my new videos. In today's video, I am bringing you a new to me brand. This is another haul also from my Black Friday sales hauls that I got, well, on Black Friday. So this one is from Death Valley Nails. They are a brand that I had been eyeing for quite some time, but they are on this slightly higher price point of indie polishes. So I had been hesitating and I wasn't really sure which polishes I wanted to try because they do have quite a large selection, but we'll go over a little bit more about their different kinds that they have once we get into the haul. They were having a 20% off sale for Black Friday, so I went ahead and grabbed some polishes. So let's go ahead and see what I got. Looks like they've got some custom tissue paper or paper wrap for the boxes that says Death Valley Nails on it. My receipt. So I got a total of 10 polishes. They have these cute custom boxes with a design on all four sides. Very pretty. So this first one is Honey on Rye. Sort of a rusty pumpkin. Next up is this periwinkle shade called Flint Wishing It Was Fluorite. Next up is another orange shade, this time in more of like a turmeric shade. This one is called, I'm probably going to butcher this, but I think that might be Coquelicot. I am not too sure about that. Next up, we've got a pink shimmer shade called Chicka Chicka Boom Boom. This one is a specialty formula, so you have some shimmer and hollow in there. I tried to make sure that I grabbed a number of different formulas from them. Next up is another shimmer shade. This one is called Citrine. This is one of their specialty shades that is from their Dust to Dust collection that is actually going to have bits of, I think, citrine in this one. So you've got some shimmer in there as well. Next up, we've got one of their multi-chromes. This one is called Snake Oil. This one looked really interesting. I'm excited to see how this one is going to swatch. Next up is one of their purples. This one is called High Horse Mama, and this one has a beautiful blue shimmer to it. Next up is another orange, this time with a pink flash to it. This one is called High Plains. I thought this one was really, really unique. Next up is another one of their shimmer polishes. This one is called Celestine, and it is from South Bass Island, Ohio. So this is another part of their Dust to Dust collection. So it's going to have bits of their hand-crushed pigments in there. And last but not least, we've got another shimmer polish, and this one is called Star Smut. And this one does not seem to be from their Dust to Dust collection, but it's got a shimmer component and some hollow micro glitter. All right, so I've got these sort of organized by type. We've got the Dust to Dust collection. I got two from there. I then went ahead and did the other sheer shimmer polish next to that. We've got our three oranges, one of which I think might technically be part of the Dust to Dust because it does contain one of their hand ground components in there. That one has ochre in it. But I did pair it next to the two other oranges because it doesn't specifically say even on the website that it is part of their Dust to Dust collection. So I just thought I'd specify that. Then I went into our purples, our pink, and then our multi-chrome here at the end. So one of their, I think, founding collections was their Dust to Dust. At least that's when I first remember hearing about them. And these basically have their hand-forged pigments from the earth made into nail polish. Now, a couple of the more unusual ones are actual plant components like ground up leaves. They also have charred bones that have been ground up into nail polish components as well. Some of those were just a little bit too far outside my comfort zone as far as polishes that I think I would even be interested in wearing. So I did stick to the ones that I was more intrigued by and that were in colors that I would like. This one is called Celestine, and as far as I can tell, it is made with that stone from Bass Island and hand ground into a particle that could be used in nail polish. So I'm not really sure what particle you're going to be seeing it as in the nail polish, but the base of this is a light green, just a jelly, sort of a squishy formula with a beautiful shifting shimmer that I'm seeing in like a blurple at the face. but I'm also seeing some red pop up at certain angles. We've also got some beautiful twinkles throughout this polish. So again, I'm not sure which particulate is the hand ground one, but it is a really beautiful combination. The next one from the Dust to Dust collection is Citrine. So this one is going to have crushed up citrine in it. This one comes from Franklin, North Carolina. So this one I thought would be a really interesting one to try because of the shimmer particulates in this one. You do have a really beautiful shifting shimmer in there. So again, I'm curious how this one is going to swatch. And then the other one that has hand ground pigmentation in it is this one called Coquelicot. Again, I am not sure if I'm pronouncing that correctly. Feel free to enlighten me. It's hard to see, but at certain angles you can sort of see a little bit of shadow on one side of the bottle, which I don't think is going to translate at all. A few of these are cream shades, a couple have shimmers in with a cream, and then this one over here, which was Chicka Chicka Boom Boom, is one of the more specialty finishes because it does have hollow in there. So let's go ahead and get swatching. All right, so we're going to be trying out this new setup. Hopefully this makes it easier for me to share swatches with you. The first one that we're going to look at is Celestine, sourced from South Bass Island in Ohio. So this one is definitely going to be a jelly formula. In fact, on this first coat, I'm not really seeing much in the way of color. But there it is in one coat. Let's go ahead and see it in a second coat. So definitely a squishy jelly base. I still don't really see too much in the way of color on the nail. I am getting some of that shimmer and of course the twinkles in there as well. Let's go ahead and see a third coat. So there is three coats of Celestine. This one was originally $15. Like I said, they were having a 20% off for Black Friday. The bottles are a really good size. They are 16.5 ml, which is a bit bigger than your standard 15 ml bottle. I will say this one is definitely not the most exciting on the nail. I'm really not seeing too much, even in three coats. But this could make a very interesting topper over other colors. So I might have to play around with how that looks. I do think, however, in other lighting, you are able to see some of that purple shimmer pop up. So again, maybe more of a transformative topper polish. I don't know if that purple's gonna show off very well. I think you can kind of see it starting to glow there. So let's go ahead and just try a fourth to see if I can't amp up a little bit of color. Nope, I think this one is strictly a topper. So that is fourth coat there. It does add a very sparse smattering of the particulates across the nail. Mainly what you're going to get, I think, is that subtle glow. So that one was Celestine. Next up is another shimmer polish. This one is Citrine, also from their Dust to Dust collection. This one was also originally $15 before the discount. And the components sourced for this one came from Franklin, North Carolina. Here we have that first coat. We are again starting off with a sheerer base. On this one, I am seeing the red particulates nicely there on the nail though, as well as a scattering throughout of something else, my larger component that looks to be a bit grittier than your standard glitter. So that might be the crushed citrine. Let's go ahead and take a look at a second coat of that one. So there is two coats. I think this one is also meant more as a topper. It's definitely still very sheer in those two coats. I'm not really even seeing much in the way of that yellow base come out, which if you're a regular, you'll know I'm fine with. Yellows are not my favorite. So this one should work nicely as a topper over other colors. And I really do like the size of the particulates in there. That shimmer is really, really pretty. And now that we have something else to look at, I think you can definitely see that purple glow that I was talking about on Celestine. So let's go ahead and see a third coat. The glow on this one definitely builds up nicely. Again, I'm really seeing that red shimmer in there. I wouldn't necessarily say that there's something unusual about either of these offhand. So if you were worried about larger pigments or a super gritty texture, at least on these swatches, I'm not necessarily noticing anything too abnormal. I think we will go ahead and do a fourth coat on this one as well, since we did do that for Celestine. So there's our fourth coat. Definitely a beautiful shimmer in this one. I think it's my favorite of the two, but I can definitely see the glow of that purple one looking absolutely beautiful over certain colors. I want to say that this one in the sun looked absolutely beautiful, if it's the one that I'm remembering from the swatches on the website. That one positively glowed outside. So that one was Citrine. Next up is another shimmer polish. This one has more of a pink cast to it with a little bit of hollow glitter in there. This one is called Star Smut. This one was also originally $15 before the 20% off. And this one is one of their, we'll just call them regular polishes, not part of the Dust to Dust collection. Let's see how that pink shifts to a beautiful blue. I think this is another one where the swatches looked positively glowing. In fact, this one might be the one that I was thinking of, because that's that blue glow that I'm remembering. Really pretty. So here's that first coat of Star Smut. We've got a soft glow of that shimmer with a scattering of the holographic glitters, very twinkly. Let's take a look at a second coat of that one. I think this is going to be another one in a more sheer formula. I don't think that you're going to be able to build this one to full opacity. I'm really liking the glitters that are in this one though, very twinkly. And I think the glow on this one is going to be beautiful as well. Let's go ahead and do a third coat of Star Smut. Building up that glow and those glitter twinkles. I think now that we have a few different ones on the wheel, you can sort of see the base colors ever so slightly by comparison to each other. Very soft and ethereal colors, to be sure. So since we did it for the other two, let's go ahead and give Star Smut a fourth coat. Again, I don't think you're going to be able to build it up, but it'll give us the most color. So that is our fourth coat. This one does have a really nice, pretty impactful shimmer to it by comparison. In person, I'm seeing a pink to purple. On camera, you're mostly seeing like a blue, so this one should be nice and shifty. Again, you've got a nice twinkle to those glitters as well. I'll see about getting these outside as well to try to get them in different lighting so that you can see how they look. That one was Star Smut. All right, on to one of our cream shades. This one is, I keep second guessing how I'm pronouncing this, but Coquelicot. And this one has ground ochre in it. So this one should be much more opaque. I was really looking forward to seeing this color as well. Of course, fall is gone, but I am looking forward to wearing this next fall. So let's go ahead and take a look at the first coat. In the swatching, I can definitely see little tiny particulates. But this one is, as expected, much more opaque. It's not gritty or anything, but you can see it when you're applying it. But this is a beautiful color. I think ochre would be a pretty good descriptor as well as far as the color goes, which would of course make sense. There you go. I think there you can sort of see what I'm talking about, those little teeny tiny particulates right there. I don't think, again, that they're super gritty or anything like that. Probably no bigger than pigmentation that just hasn't dissolved into a polish from your everyday pigments. All right, let's go ahead and do a second coat. So there's our second coat of Coquelicot. This one's definitely good and opaque in two coats. I would have a hard time seeing anyone need more than two. Again, this color is really, really pretty. I think it's going to be gorgeous for fall. And it's fairly unusual among the other oranges in my collection. This particular shade of burnt ochre orange is very, very interesting. There's a pinch of like caramel in it that's really, really beautiful. And again, very unusual orange in my collection. And in that second coat, I definitely don't see anything too out of the ordinary as far as particulate sizes or grittiness. So there's two coats of Coquelicot. Next up is a peachier orange. This one is called Honey on Rye 195. They had a lot of really beautiful shades of orange. I actually had quite a few more shades in my cart before I made myself cut a few out. I did get three, which is still more than I had wanted to get, considering I have quite the collection of oranges for fall. But I thought this was an unusual shade of this sort of burnt peach. This one also has an interesting sort of component in there. I don't know if you can see these little tiny particulates. Let's try zooming in again on this one. I think you can see what I'm talking about as far as the little tiny particulates in the bottle. As far as I can tell, this one is just meant as a cream polish. I didn't see anything listed on the website as far as this being from the Dust to Dust collection. So that might just be some of the pigmentation that they've used in the bottle. And I don't remember if I said for Coquelicot, but that one was originally $12 before the 20% off discount. And Honey on Rye was also $12 before the discount. So here is coat one of Honey on Rye. This one is a little bit less pigmented than Coquelicot. There we have one coat, that beautiful peachy shade. I really like the tone of this one as well. It's an earthy peach, not a pastel or washed out peach by any means. So I think this one will be another unique shade in my collection. And again, in one coat, I think you can see what I mean about that pigmentation. See that little tiny, almost stripe? That's my guess is that is just the pigments that haven't quite incorporated into the polish. So just something to keep in mind. These are hand mixed. And again, I'm not sure if that one was supposed to be part of their Dust to Dust collection, but I didn't see anything listed on the website. Let's go ahead and do a second coat. So there you have two coats of Honey on Rye. Again, I think this is a lovely peachy shade, more on the earthy side than most of the other peaches that I have. It's got that slight dusty quality and a bit of like almost a terracotta lean, but it's still definitely in a peach family to my eyes. Again, really unique to my collection. That's one of the things that I really like about even their cream formulas is that a lot of the colors that they had seemed really unique. So that was two coats of Honey on Rye. Next up is High Plains. This one was originally $12 before the discount as well. This one has a shimmer in it, which look at that. I had to get this one because of that contrast between the shimmer and this orange base. That is very unusual. I think I only have one other polish, maybe two. One that I can think of that came from BC Belacquer that has an orange base with an unusual shimmer to it. So I had to see this one in person. I think this one is super unique. So let's see how High Plains looks in one coat. This one is more like a deep cantaloupe shade. And because it does have a shimmer component, it is a bit sheerer than our creams. But not too bad. I think this one will be opaque in two, three coats. It's got a bit more yellow in that base. And pardon my application, I could have been a little bit more precise. I think I've got some polish pooling off to the side of that nail a little. Let's go ahead and see a second coat of High Plains. Yeah, I think some people might be okay with this in two coats. There it is. Look at that beautiful pink in there. So beautiful. This is going to look gorgeous on. I think this is going to be such a fun summer shade. So that was two coats of High Plains. Next up is another cream, this time in a beautiful periwinkle shade. I could not resist getting this one. This one is Flint Wishing It Was Fluorite. This one was also originally $12 Most of their creams seem to be that price point, again, before that 20% discount. This is a really nice color for the very Perry color of the year for 2022. And as a Purple and Blurple fan, this is a color that I've always really, really enjoyed. So I was excited to see them have a color like it. Let's go ahead and see how it swatches. So this one has a slightly crelly formula, just a pinch on the squishy side. Beautiful color though. I would almost call this a cross between like a periwinkle and a cornflower blue. There's a pinch of that dusty blue quality to it. So if you were to put it on a scale between purple and blue, it would be on that dusty side right there, just crossing the line from purple to blue. I really, really love all tones of purple, blurple, periwinkle, cornflower. They're all beautiful variations of mixing blue and purple together. Absolutely love it. Let's go ahead and see a second coat. I think I might have wiped up a bit too much of polish from my wand there. So there's our second coat of Flint Wishing It Was Fluorite. Again, I love this tone. I think this is going to be one of those colors that, depending on your lighting situation, you might find it looks more blue, it might look more purple, or in some lighting, it might even look grayer. I love colors that do that, especially when they're creams and it's not so much a shift as it is just a change in how the color plays with the light. This is a gorgeous color. And I think most people might be okay with two coats on this one. Very long nails like stiletto length might need a third, but I think it's nice and opaque in two. Willa wants in. Hang on. You should see her begging at the door. We've got kind of wide gaps under the door that are probably about, I don't know, an inch and a half tall. And she sticks a paw under the door and then puts her little mouth by the gap and meows underneath the door to be let in. She's a goofy one. So that was two coats of Flint Wishing It Was Fluorite. I think that one might have to go on my winter rack. Next up is one of their polishes that is a cream base with a shimmer component. I know! This one is called High Horse Mama, and this is a really beautiful warm toned purple, if I'm not mistaken. Then you have the contrasting blue shimmer. I don't think this comes as a surprise to anybody that I really love this combination. You have the blue against this purple, and it's a really fun tone of purple as well. It's got that pinch of like a neon coloration to it, and that shimmer in there is really, really gorgeous. This one was originally $14 before the discount. So as expected, because there is a shimmer particulate in this one, it's a bit on the sheerer side, but I think this one should also be okay in two coats, maybe three on longer nails. But beautiful shimmer again, and the tone of this is just beautiful. Let's go ahead and take a look at a second coat of High Horse Mama. So there's two coats. This is beautifully opaque in two. Again, really, really long nails, might need a third. What, Willabean? But the shimmer shows up really nicely on the nail. It's not exactly a super pow in your face shimmer, but you can definitely see it. Again, the tone of this purple is absolutely gorgeous. I think this one will have to come out next summer. So that was two coats of High Horse Mama. Next up is the pink. This one is called Chicka Chicka Boom Boom. And this one has a beautiful green flash to it that shifts to gold at the edges. There's also a holographic component in there as well. This one was originally $14 before the discount. I think there you can see that holographic. So let's take a look at Chicka Chicka Boom Boom in one coat. This one is definitely a squishy base, but I think this one might be opaque for us in three. It's got a beautiful shimmer going throughout. And I think there's another component in here as well besides the shimmer and the holo. I'm seeing a smattering of something else in there. There it is in one coat up close. I don't know if you can see that other particulate that I'm talking about, sort of right there, just a little tiny speckle. There's just a touch of that throughout, so I'm not sure what other component that one is. Let's go ahead and see a second coat. We've got a bit more color built up on that second coat, a bit more of that shimmer. It's a nice medium toned shade of pink. Let's go ahead and see how a third coat builds up. So I would say shorter nails might be okay with a third coat, but longer nails might need a fourth to reach full opacity on this one. But there it is in three coats. As you can still see my nail line underneath it, but you do get a nice wash of that pink color. And look at that shimmer. That is really, really pretty. I will say the holographic doesn't translate to necessarily a linear on the nail, but it does add a really beautiful sparkle to the nail. And of course, I love the green popping against this beautiful pink. Pinks aren't necessarily my go-to favorite color, but I thought that the combination in this one was really nice. And it is a soft, delicate sort of color. I think it'll look really beautiful on. And since this one is pretty sheer on its own, you could also play around with this as a transformative topper over other colors. So that was three coats of Chicka Chicka Boom Boom. And then lastly, we have our multichrome. This one is Snake Oil. And this one was originally $15 before the discount. This one I thought was a very interesting multichrome. In the bottle, what I'm mainly seeing from my angle is a green to like a bronze. On camera, I'm seeing like a fuchsia to deep, almost like smoky brown. But on the edge of the bottle over here, you can see some orange pop up. So lots going on in this. There's also a scattering of a holographic glitter in here. So let's see how Snake Oil swatches. So this one is a bit on the sheerer side, kind of like Chicka Chicka Boom Boom was. This one looks really beautiful and twinkly on the nail. I'm also seeing another particle in here as well. I don't know if maybe that's the glitter. There's a close-up of some of the components in there. See those beautiful twinkles. Love the red that I'm seeing. Let's go ahead and see a second coat. It definitely doesn't build up too much in that second coat. I would say maybe longer nails might need a fourth even, but we'll see when we get there. I think on camera you can see that beautiful pink flash starting to get nice and strong. I think this one for myself is probably a good candidate to wear over a black or a very dark green. That is really, really pretty. Let's go ahead and see a third coat. So here is three coats of Snake Oil. As you can still see my nail underneath it. Shorter nails might be okay with three coats, but I think longer nails would benefit from wearing this one over either a blurring base coat or a matching undie like a black or a dark green. But the shifts on this are really very beautiful. On camera, you're mainly seeing that fuchsia, but in person, I'm seeing the golds, oranges, and greens. What's interesting is in person, I don't really see the twinkles of the glitter, but I can see them twinkling away on camera. So that was three coats of Snake Oil. Now, because I am curious about how this is gonna look over a black undie, I think what I'm gonna do is just put black nail polish on the underside of it, just to see what that'll look like. In fact, I think what I might do is put a half coat of black underneath our three sheerer polishes as well. All right, well, wouldn't you know it, I got some black nail polish on me, but here we go. There's our three half nails underneath our sheerer polishes. Two of those were from the Dust to Dust collection. I ended up also doing just a half underneath Snake Oil. That way I could still see what it looked like on its own. So as you can see, over black, you definitely get more of a punch of that shifting multichrome. You can see some of that warmer tones pop up in certain lighting. And again, I'll try to get these outside so you can see them in daylight as well. So there you have it. That was my first look at Death Valley Nails. If you have any from this brand, feel free to share them down below. If you have any favorites that I need to check out, definitely let me know about those. Overall, I think I got to try a number of different formulas from them, everything from their sheer toppers to some creams as well as shimmers and one multi-chrome. There were a few other colors that I was very intrigued by that they were sold out on during their Black Friday sale, so I might have to check in on those. I don't remember the names of any of those on hand, but one of them was nice and shiny and sparkly. I will say that these were much, much sheerer. These three, the Celestine, Citrine, and Star Smut, were a lot sheerer than I was expecting. They are very, very pretty though. As you can see, you do get a lot of glow when you put them over a darker color. That is them half over black. So this one here was Celestine, this is Citrine, and this one is Star Smut. That one has the most opacity of the three of them. You get that sort of a cloudy look with four coats. I also really enjoyed the unique colors that we got. I feel like, especially with the oranges, we got some very unique shades. And this particular one here, which is Flint Wishing It Was Fluorite, is an absolutely stunning shade. So overall, I'm pretty pleased with the ones that I chose. I still think I would wait until there's a sale, personally, for me to go back and get some more. But that's just my own personal preference. Again, let me know down below if you have any favorites. I also did really like the brush that they picked. It was nice and easy to use. It was a wide flat brush, sort of like a paddle brush with a rounded edge. One of my preferred styles of brushes. Also, I do really like that you get a large amount in each bottle. Like I said, they are 16.5 ml. And I really like their sort of back to nature aesthetic with them using ground products, ochre and gemstones. Although bone to me is still a bit outside my wheelhouse as far as the kind of polish that I could see myself using. So I'm curious to see what other pigmentations they come out with in future collections. And I think that about wraps up my first impressions and my first haul from Death Valley Nails. As always, thank you so much for hanging out with me. Hopefully you enjoyed. Do feel free to leave comments down below about the new format for how I'm doing swatches. I know I could definitely tweak that up, but as always, thank you so much for joining me and hanging out. Hopefully you enjoyed and had a good time, and I will see you in that next one.